Red Wings Hockey on Fox Sports Detroit is brought to you by Comcast, a better value in TV, and by the Ramani Eye Institute, the most trusted name in eye care. Our goaltenders here in Phoenix, Jimmy Howard, a fifth straight start and eighth of the past nine. 937 save percentage over the month of December. And third best goals against in the league since the end of November. Jimmy Howard's been very good, and so is this guy. Perhaps the Phoenix Coyotes MVP, if not in the entire league. He's won games on his own this season, tied for third best save percentage, second goals against, leads and shutouts, 37th game out of 43 for Phoenix. Eric Furlatte is number 27. Francois Saint-Laurent is number 38. The Red Wings have Pavel Datsyuk at center, Todd Bertuzzi on the left, and Thomas Holmstrom on the right. Pavel Datsyuk will see a lot of number 11, Martin Hansel, one of the better defensive centers in the National Hockey League. He tied up Joe Thornton two nights ago, although San Jose did win here in a shootout, the first loss in 11 home games for Phoenix. It hasn't lost since November 16th in this building in regulation. And it's an all-check line up front for the Coyotes. As Hansel goes in after the puck, tried to get it to Radim Verbata. Peter Pruka, a fellow Czech, on the other side. Point shot that just went wide by Zabinek Mihalik. Another check as Howard got a piece of that and deflected it. And Todd Bertuzzi in his 900th NHL game couldn't clear it around in behind. Loose in front of the goal. It came right back in front. Batted away. Finally, Brad Stewart says enough of this to the line, but not out. Verbata held one in. Stewart trying to tie up his check on the far side. Came to the line and pushed back into the corner. And now the Coyotes and Red Wings will both change. But a flurry there in the opening 40 seconds for the Phoenix Coyotes. As Brian Rafalski, our guest in our open, thanks to John Keating, move one ahead, and Doug Janik in the rest of the way to Matias Ritola, who stays in the lineup tonight with Brad May nursing a lower body injury. Valtteri Filppula cleared one back, and it's out to center for Rafalski. Over to Doug Janik. Janik with a rink-wide feed that's a good one. Drew Miller takes a hit, gets one into Valtteri Filppula. Matias Ritola moving away from Keith Yandle. Out to Miller, a shot! And Brizgalov got that with the right pad as Adrian O'Coin, who had an overtime winner here early in the season to beat the Red Wings. Both final scores in this series thus far, 3-2. Red Wings won at the Joe with Jimmy Howard making 30 saves that night. Phoenix won in here. Howard held the short side and another stop on Taylor Byatt.
Phoenix Coyotes had a poor outing almost 3 weeks ago, their last game against the Wings, and the one thing they wanted to make sure coming into this one is that they are prepared and started off well, and it has been the case. As the Coyotes create a good scoring chance as Pyatt, one of the big Coyotes that have played so well of late, had a good scoring opportunity.
Coyotes win that faceoff. Thrown back in by Scotty Upshaw, number 8, out there with Shane Doan, number 19, and Matthew Lombardi, number 15. Patrick Eaves back out for the Red Wings after missing time due to the flu. Lombardi will shoot it. Howard will stop. Moving in on it is Upshaw. What a season Scotty Upshaw's having.
Well on his way to a career year, 15 being his highest total last season. This year he's got 14 already.
And this has been a good line for them. Matthew Lombardi, who was a huge scorer in junior hockey, number 15, who had to go off his skate then regain control, has really turned into a good two-way center now. Doan colliding there with Justin Ablocator, who's the Red Wing team leader in hits. Ablocator out there with Maltby and Ville Leino, who had the huge goal on New Year's Eve for the Red Wings. And after sitting a few as a healthy scratch, Leino came up with a good game. And not just the goal, Larry. He was all over the ice.
Good hard work grinding it out in the corners.
Maltby and Ablocator into the corner along with Jeff Hogan. It comes back to the point for Stewart, a shot and it's tipped. Ablocator going after the puck into the corner for Leino. Tried to work it back into Ablocator. Leno's got it one more time in his backhand. Got knocked down to the ice. Derek Beach, who also had a good outing on New Year's Eve, assisting on the Leino goal. That's clear to the line. Kevin Porter, number 23, former Michigan Wolverine. And we'll get a call on the faceoff coming back into the Red Wing zone.
The hero of New Year's Eve, Ville Leino. He's had a tough time of it late, scoring goals. finishes off an outstanding shift. He lost his helmet battling for the puck earlier on. Gets himself right in the shooting lane. Deflects the meat shot. This is somebody that desperately needs to get some scoring. He's in the lineup to produce that, and he hasn't done that as much as they had hoped this season.
It turned out to be the game-winning goal. Darren Helm out of the empty netter.
That was his first goal in 21 games for Atlanta. And he starts getting some confidence. The numbers should pick up considerably.
Holmstrom up with Datsyuk and Bertuzzi. Datsyuk, there's Hanzel. All over him one more time. Martin Hanzel, big body at 6'3", 216. Radim Berbata up for Peter Prucha. Thomas Holmstrom. Hanzel ran into him. Holmstrom, another attempt to the line, but not out. Backhanded in. Oh, great save by Howard. Peter Prucha point blank, and Howard stopped. Hanzel lost it. Rafalski's got it. Ahead for Todd Bertuzzi. Bertuzzi slowly, he'll lift a high one in. 8 goals the past 10 for Todd Bertuzzi, who went down and behind the goal, cleared around by McCulloch for Shane Doan. Doan into the zone, and he got stood up by Stewart and gave him a hit back. Point shot in front. Well, he took note on those numbers. Here goes Upshaw as he runs at Drew Miller. Ritola trying to get a piece of Anders Ericsson, took the puck. Yes, Anders Ericsson, the former Red Wings, still in the league, finding employment. And good for him. And just found work, oh, 6 or 7 games ago here with Phoenix. Drew Miller back to the line. He'll settle it back in behind the goal for Sammy Lepisto. One of the two Olympians. He'll play for Finland in Vancouver. Zbenek McCulloch will play for the Czech Republic. Lepisto in his third season, former Washington Capitals draft selection. Gave it away at center ice. Valtteri Filppula, who will play for Finland in Vancouver. Lebda turns in his own zone, chased there by Peter Mueller, and turned right back into the check. Mueller able to get the puck, but intercepted there by Draper. Draper up with Eaves and Helm. And it's knocked away and out to center. Lebda's back, but here comes Mueller. Mueller on the left wing side of the middle, and the shot went wide. Helm able to get it out to center, and the pass is too far for Draper, and turning there is Zbenek McCulloch. Younger brother Milan is in Ottawa, who went over there on the Danny Heatley deal. Robert Lang got one back for Mueller. Just one goal in the year for Peter Mueller, Larry.
Nothing in the last 20. What? That's the, probably offensively the biggest disappointment for the Coyotes this season.
The Minnesota native was the 8th overall pick in 2006. Really struggling. The Coyotes don't have a lot of their young kids who are in the American Hockey League this year, as that'll be held by Howard. The likes of Kyle Turris and Mikhail Botker buying a trade in the American League. They're going more with veterans, and they're winning. We're back in a moment.
Boy, what a season this has turned out to be for Jimmy Howard. And after a slow start the last couple of months, he's played up to the level of this man at the other end, Rizgalov. Look at the company Jimmy Howard is keeping. Chris Paul Huey, 2.0. The Hawks, a tough team to score against. Luongo, Kiprusoff. Jimmy Howard is playing a lion's share of the games now because of his level of play.
Coyotes control that draw, and there's a good stop by Jimmy Howard. His .921 save percentage is tied with Marty Brodeur for 10th best in the league. But that save percentage is 6th best in the NHL of goalies in 20 or more games played. So that's how, somewhat quiet, Jimmy Howard has really come on. And at the start of the year, Larry, the Red Wings were hoping to get him into 25 or 30 games. Tonight's his 25th.
Yeah, the thinking was, hopefully they can squeeze him in for that many.
Right.
Now they can't get him out of the net. He started 7 of the last 8 games, and that's because of his level of play. He's earned that.
There's a hold coming here to Phoenix. Delayed penalty to the Coyotes as Mitchell turned back as Howard goes to the bench for an extra skater. Fans are booing, but not much doubt about that one. Datsyuk tried to get a shot through. Datsyuk has owned the Coyotes with 42 points in 28 career games. Puck's loose. Bertuzzi's got it. Threw it back to the line. Oh, look out here. It went through Lidstrom. It'll roll wide, thankfully. That was close. Todd Bertuzzi threw it back. Lidstrom missed it. Had that gone in, it would have counted a goal for Phoenix. And Bertuzzi nearly broke through, and they just call that.
That's something you don't see too often. But it has happened in the past. Coyotes do not get possession of the puck, and you're free to shoot it in your own net. The Wings come close to it. The one complaint, or the one knock against the Phoenix Coyotes, is that they take too many penalties. Verbata, not thinking, gets that free hand in on the play, puts them on the PK. Good thing for Phoenix, especially this home run. Winning 10 of their last 11 home games is that their penalty killing has been outstanding. Put to the test early in this one.
Red Wings power play struggled, just 5 for 54 the month of December. Bell Tire power play here in Detroit. Mitchell hustle over, is able to hold it in, but he's pressured and sent down the ice by Phoenix. Meach and Stewart, Retila, Filppula, Advocator, first power play unit Detroit. Stewart across the line to Meach. Retila behind the net. And that'll be sent down. Howard will come out and play it before the goal line.
The wrath of injuries to the Red Wings, we're seeing power play combinations that we never imagined we would see at the start of this season.
Lidstrom will clear it deep as Datsyuk comes out with Bertuzzi and Holmstrom, who blocks it to Bertuzzi. Rafalski to Lidstrom, looking for his first goal in 38. Datsyuk will shoot. Holmstrom will rebound. Cleared up into the middle. Very patiently sent the length of the ice by Hanzel.
Two of their key penalty killers are injured, and it's counting on guys like Hanzel to pick up their PK time.
Holmstrom. Bertuzzi quickly back. Rafalski to the net. Crowd in front. And that's one way to beat Brizgalov. Get a crowd in front. He sees it. He'll stop it more often than not. Holmstrom in front. Rafalski for Bertuzzi, and a tip just wide. Datsyuk back the middle. Bertuzzi lifted a stick. And good play, Todd Bertuzzi, as Holmstrom had an attempt at it.
Strong in front of the net. You nailed it, Ken. Brizgalov sees the puck. He's going to stop it. And Rafalski early in that shift. Perfect pass that Bertuzzi redirected and then lifted the stick and allowed Thomas Holmstrom to almost have a great scoring chance. Boy, Bertuzzi is hot, and boy, you can see it in his level of play, brimming with confidence, shooting the puck well, passing it well, skating well.
Penalty coming here to the Red Wings, as they'll touch this puck with 17 seconds left on their power play. They'll go four aside for that time, and then Phoenix to the man advantage.
After winning the draw, the Coyotes got out quick. Justin Ablicator cannot hold up. Ablicator off the faceoff, comes into the middle of the circle and impedes the progress of the Coyote player. Got to let him go. Can't touch him off. Drop of the puck. You have to let him have clean track right up to the blue line.
So four aside here. Robert Lang on the faceoff against Chris Draper. Phoenix held an optional skate this morning. Only three players showed. Red Wings practiced this morning here at Jobbing.com Arena in Glendale.
A little earlier than normal because of the 6 o'clock start.
You're here at the rink at 8:30 this morning. Long shot in that Brizgalov stopped.
Which is not so bad considering at East Coast it's 10:30 time, so right. Their body clocks hadn't adjusted yet on this trip.
And you know Mike Babcock, who never sleeps, made sure everyone knew that. Back of the goal for Taylor Pyatt. It's 10:30 back home, don't worry about it. Here's O'Coin getting it across to Jovanovski, to Robert Lang, to Jovanovski. The Windsor native put it back in front. Eaves is there to intercept. Helm.
What a tremendous job those two, Eaves and Helm, have done for the Wings on the PK. They're a huge part of this much improved PK unit.
And Drew Miller and Maltby, a nice second unit to come out there too.
We've always got Nick Lidstrom, and Brad Stewart's having an outstanding season. He's been extremely effective. Brad Stewart plus 3 against the Avs last game.
Maltby cleared it back into the corner.
Red Wing penalty killing. You see the last 16 games, how successful they have been. And a large part of that is goaltending. That's why Howard's save percentage is as good as it is, as that comes in offside.
Oh, Mahalik takes it back. On the backhand, puck rolling. Oh! I realized the moment he brought it back in. How about the job Dave Tippett has done with this team? Coming in late in training camp and still able to implement a sound defensive strategy for this team.
Coyotes in on the man advantage. Mahalik in for Doan. Stewart feathered one through for Helm, delayed a bit and got it out to center. And the Red Wings return to full strength. Applicator's penalty is over. Brought in by Yandle. Saved by Howard. Cleared back in behind by Pruka. Goes after it in the corner, but Datsu will swing one ahead to Janik. For Applicator as Janik rushes in and he'll force Przegalla to hold. 8:43 to go, first period. No scoring yet in Glendale.
Scoring the heroic goal against, or the shorthanded goal against Colorado Rockies. Darren Helm continues with strong PK play. Him and Eves out high. Helm on the right side, Eves on the left side, and they break up the play. And out Brad Stewart. Boy, a veteran move, a little chip shot to Helm, allows him to get the puck out of the zone. The Wings penalty kill unit working well together.
Last 17 games, just 5 power play goals against. 2 last game versus Colorado. Both by Yip.
See,
since November 27th, best penalty killing percentage in the NHL.
Concerned now for teams when Helm's on the ice. Because of his speed, and if you're not careful, the blue line, he's either going to draw a penalty or get a scoring, good scoring chance right on the PK.
Pruka turning back. Mahalik up the middle to Pruka. Look for Batta. And a save by Howard. We'll hold on to that off the shot from Hansel. Score the $48 family pack to see the Red Wings battle the Carolina Hurricanes on Thursday, January 14th. You'll get 2 tickets, 2 hot dogs, and 2 sodas, plus all fans get a free Red Wings tote bag. For tickets, visit DetroitRedWings.com. Face off to the right of Jimmy Howard, who is 6-3-1 his past 10 games with a 1.69 goals against average in that span of 10. If only his team provided him with a little more offense, there may not even be 3 losses there in the regulation time. Well, that will bode well when the Red Wings begin to get healthy bodies back. And by the same token, they want to find some time to get Chris Osgood back on his game. He's just 4 wins shy of 400 in his career. Ritola to the goal! Oh, and that bounced off Przegalla, but he very calmly grabbed that.
Well, Philpola stays on side at the blue line. What drags that leg? Once the puck gets across, he goes to the net. Ritola's shot. Well, Perry's right there for the deflection. And Ritola, he's looking to get comfortable in the National Hockey League. He hasn't played a lot. It takes time.
Off the faceoff and a shot from Rafalski. Skalov will hold on to that. This game is available in crystal clear high definition on Fox Sports Detroit HD, sponsored by Comcast. And glad you're with us on this Saturday evening from Glendale. And a pretty good crowd here for Phoenix. And Red Wings in town on a Saturday night, that doesn't hurt. Shane Doan goes wide. Lidstrom back to pick it up.
Great home record of late, doesn't hurt either.
Yeah. Club record, 10 consecutive wins, and losing here New Year's Eve to San Jose in a shootout penalty. Coming here to Phoenix, Shane Doan. Roughing the call, Eric Ferlat the referee.
Well, penalty number 2 for the Coyotes, and Another penalty. I don't think he expected Bufalstra to go down as easily as he did. Caught him by surprise. The Coyotes have to stay out of the box. And that's the one area they've got to clean up. This team has played so well for Dave Tippett. Such a disciplined team, but they seem to march too often through the penalty box.
Off that faceoff, Hansel away from Datsyuk. Datsyuk staying with him, the league leader in takeaways, tried to take one away right there, and Hansel will just drop it in deep. Datsyuk coming up behind Lidstrom. He'll cut to the middle now, and Lidstrom will drop it to him. Datsyuk in across the line, getting it to Holmstrom. Lidstrom, good kick save and a beauty to hold it in. Nice play by Bertuzzi to get it back to him. Rafalski will shoot it. Brzgalov stopped it, and he found it.
A little soccer before the game doesn't hurt. Lidstrom sticks his foot out, keeps it in to Bertuzzi. The Wings once again get the puck towards the net, but Brzgalov quick to jump on the rebound. Nick Lidstrom looking to start lighting the lamp once again. He's offensively just having a tough go of it this season.
Meech back with Stewart. Felpola Rittel abdicator. 1:10 remaining in this Bell Tire power play. Meech leaves, Felpola missed it. So now Rittel will turn back, Lombardi watching him. Felpola away from Lombardi, staying with him though. Drew it back in, tried to feed Stewart, who's in deep. Ablocated. Tied up by Pike. Puck came free, O'Coin. And with Stewart jumping in deep, that point spot is open. And it goes down nearly 200 feet. Derek Meech with his head up. Too far for Ablocated. No icing, they say. McCollum. He'll clear it around. That hit Rittel. Over the stick of Stewart and down. Howard will have to come out and play it with Martin Hansel on the move. Howard getting it across as Meech takes a look. The Red Wings change. 25 seconds left in this manpower advantage as Brian Rafalski will lead the attack. The oldest U.S. Olympian got one through, and here's Bertuzzi back to Datsyuk. Holmstrom heads to his office. In front, Lidstrom. Save me. Rebound. Holmstrom. Oh, Brzgalov comes up big. Lidstrom again. He's overdue for one. Bertuzzi across. Datsyuk shoots. Brzgalov got that. Datsyuk fending off a hit. Made the play. Power play over. Lidstrom with it. In front, they score! Holmstrom in front of the goal! I think he got a stick on that. And the Red Wings get the first one here in Phoenix. They lead 1-0.
Shot from the point. Might have hit two Wings on the way to the net. Yes, it was 5-on-5, but Coyotes do not sort out their coverage. Lidstrom shot from the point. There's Bertuzzi. There's Holmstrom. Brzgalov has no idea where the puck is. Good hard low shot. The point. Head up. Holmstrom is the last one to touch it. Tic-tac-toe. It's in the net.
His team leading 14th goal for Thomas Holmstrom is 8th. On the power play of those 14. And so key to get the first one on Phoenix, because they have the best record in the league when they get the first goal, and the Red Wings jump out first tonight. And Doan was back in the play, so it was about 10 seconds or so after the power play had expired.
It didn't sort out their coverage, and Lidstrom had plenty of time to shoot the puck.
Plenty of time for Yandel. Right to the middle. And just wide. Big shift here not to let Phoenix come back. Taylor Pyatt. Put it back in. It goes off the skate. A shot. And Howard stopped that. With Robert Lang in on the play. Pyatt kicking one ahead. Behind the goal, Mueller. Back in for Pyatt. Stewart stick checking him. Turning it back in. Lepisto got it over to Yandel in front on a tip for Lang. They pull it back. Oh, great clear. Oh, Howard, a diving stop, lost his stick. He got some help in behind and made a great save. Howard doesn't have his stick yet, and he's still not going to get it. Now he is. He wanted to be sure the Coyotes couldn't try a long shot down ice.
while he was out of the net. Under four to go here, opening period. Big hit thrown in there. As a pair of 28s came together. Back to the line, O'Coin knocked away. Slowed down by Rintala. Moved ahead by Miller. Over to Filppula. Banked it off the kick plate to Miller, who's hit by O'Coin. Filppula came in, second man, drew one back. Dangling with it, got it through to Rintala. To the net, that hit a body. And it'll be picked up in the corner there by Anders Eriksson with his sixth National Hockey League team. Janik will throw it back in. Rintala in the corner, all alone as the Red Wings change. Good work to keep it in tight. Kevin Porter to the far side for Jeff Hogan. Fourth line out there for Phoenix. They'll get a change here as Mike Babcock throwing Holmstrom over the boards with Bertuzzi and Datsyuk. And Dave Tippett counters with his check line. Although Porter is still out there for the moment, Hansel's got a leg over the boards and he can't wait to get out and check Pavel Datsyuk. Now he will get there. But first Bertuzzi to Lidstrom, to Bertuzzi, to the goal! Oh, and the shot just went high as he was checked by Jovanovski. Puck works its way into Red Wing territory, quickly ahead, Rafalski to Bertuzzi. Turns back inside the line. Spots Malfi. He's checked to the point. Rafalski to the goal! And that went off Jovanovski and nearly hit the top corner over the left hand of Rzgalov. Lidstrom moved up on Radim Verbata to intercept. Red Wings sort out their coverage now as the line change complete. Advocator had it go off his stick. Knocked down at center by Hansen. As Phoenix wants to complete a change. Under two to go in the opening period. The edge in shots 11-9 Detroit, and the edge in the score 2-1. Shane Doan took a whack at Draper. Here comes Eves. And Rzgalov holds that. 1:40 to go, opening period. And Thomas Holmstrom gets the goal.
Big defensive play by the Wings, and no surprise, Darren Helm, the centerman, coming back. Good coverage. Mueller right there. Look at the jump on the rebound. He's able to clear it. Jimmy Howard follows through right after with a huge save. Helm off the side of the net. Howard gets himself back in front, loses his stick in the effort. Two players contributing for defensive play. And Jimmy Howard, Mickey Redman speaks about it all the time, and you can see it, body language. Jimmy Howard, tremendous amount of confidence, just the way he carries himself now when he's in the net, even when he's out of the net, making the right plays.
Stewart moving in, Holmstrom going in after it. Holmstrom's got the first Red Wing road goal since Todd Bertuzzi scored December 19th in Dallas. The Red Wings have been blanked their past two at Chicago and Columbus. Thomas Holmstrom scores the goal at even strength, his 14th of the season. And his 7th at even strength. Backing up is Meech with a minute to go. Cleared ahead and just out of the reach of Draper. Up with Helm and Eves. Oh, Red Wings have to be careful there. Make sure all skates are off the ice.
A little head count.
Yeah. Helm up along with Draper, who was checked by Robert Lang. Yandel flipped it through to Taylor Pyatt, and there's a... He wanted a penalty there as Yandel was asking why not. Didn't get one. Lidstrom right in front of his own goal as Eves knocks it out of the air with ease. And it's sent back down as Draper, pair of 33, goes into the corner along with O'Coin. Puck is flipped ahead for Taylor Pyatt. Peter Mueller a shot. As Howard hangs on to that puck. Taylor Pyatt, who came over as an unrestricted free agent this past summer from Vancouver, and it was a horrible time last April. Taylor Pyatt's fiance passed away. She was in Jamaica, was in a car accident. They were to be married this past summer. It was so unfortunate what he had to go through, and I think for him it was just a change of scenery.
to leave Vancouver. Nothing against the Canucks or anything else. I just think he needed a fresh start.
And his play, he had a tremendous December, and Dave Tippett relies on him more now as the season goes along. He's playing more and more.
Yep. So hopefully something good comes out of something so terrible. And as the first period comes to a close, and it was a good one for the Red Wings.
They have to be happy with their competitive play in this first period. The Coyotes came out determined. The Wings dealt with it, dished out their own offense. Very impressive road period for the Detroit Red Wings. Very pleased with their level of play and looking to continue that throughout the second and third.
12 shots for Detroit, 11 for the Phoenix Coyotes. Right now they've given the goal. It's Holmstrom from Lidstrom and Rafalski, but I think Bertuzzi, Larry, will get the second assist.
Should see a change.
Right
time for there. Lidstrom. He took advantage of it, fired the puck right at Bertuzzi. He got a stick on, and Holmstrom redirected it once again. Brizgalov did not have a chance on that one.
Well, Patrick Eaves is healthy, so he gets to speak with John Keating.
Yeah, I was going to take one step away from him, but we think he's shaking off the effects of the flu. How much does that sort of get in your craw a little bit, that you're just finding some traction with a new team and you have to sit out for a game to battle off a bug?
Yeah, it's frustrating. Knocked me off my feet there pretty good for a couple days, but I'm back playing and getting back in the groove.
Size up the first period, if you would, for us.
It's a pretty good period. I mean, I know we can do a lot better, and they played well, so I'd say it was pretty even. We like to play more on their end and get through the neutral zone a lot quicker.
Patrick, appreciate your time. Good luck the rest of the way.
Thank you.
Patrick Eaves getting all of his breaths back together as we head toward the second period. Let's take you back to the Call Sam studios. Mickey York has entered and has signed in, please. Mick, it's all you.
All right, John, thank you very much. Yeah, Phoenix owns the best record in the league when scoring the first goal, but only the Penguins and Devils have won more games than the Wings when allowing the first goal. So either way, the Wings were in good shape, but they'll gladly take the lead into the room after 20 minutes of play. Coming up during this first intermission update, we'll take a look at the highlights through one, and we'll get a little extra attention from Larry Murphy. That's never a bad thing. The Wings and Coyotes have played one in Phoenix. 1-0 to score.
If a Detroit player scores a hat trick, and right now Thomas Holmstrom's closest to that, bring in a copy of the summary to Arby's tomorrow and get a free order of curly fries, and you can find that summary either in your newspaper or at foxsports.com in the NHL section.
Pavel Datsyuk does not get an assist on this goal, but a big play as he bumps Jovanovski out of the way, gets full control of the puck and makes a great pass to Rafalski. Lidstrom, Bertuzzi's right in the way, and Holmstrom finally directs the puck. Everybody on the ice contributing for that goal. Pavel Datsyuk, boy, can handle the puck, can shoot it, can pass it, and if you're not on your toes, he can knock you off of it.
I'm surprised he didn't get an assist on that one, considering he's 42 points in 28 career games against Phoenix, but yep, the third assist can help too.
Now, Pavel Datsyuk is play has improved as the season has gone along. Not the greatest of starts. Thomas Holmstrom battling away. He's off to a big year this season.
Thomas Holmstrom, one of just four Red Wings to play in every game this season. As Brad Stewart stepped up on Peter Pruka right there. Bertuzzi, another one who's played in every game, along with Stewart and Lidstrom. Only Wings have managed to play in all the games. Tipped in front of the goal, came back for Rabada. He missed it. Jovanovski moved up, and that went off to the corner. Hansel takes it off the dasher. In behind for Pruka, or for Upshaw, rather. And it's cleared ahead to center. Left it to Holmstrom. A long shot. That goes high and off the glass. Bertuzzi tipped into the back of the net. Behind the goal by Brizgalov, and Jovanovski will set it up. Ahead for McCulloch. Knocked down at center. Lift of the stick by Ritola just failed to work. Digs the puck free. Jovanovski moved in on him, came up with the puck, and will backhand it into the Red Wing zone. Rafalski, great little slip pass right there to Filppula. Cross center and sent in by Miller. Filppula gets hit in the corner. Lang and O'Coin. Lang got it ahead. Good work by Drew Miller to beat Peter Mueller to the puck. Gandel Reverse that flow. Mueller's got it. He had no room to move, though, as Red Wings step up on the play. Filppula forced back at center. Rafalski gave it up at center off Pyatt, delayed offside, so they couldn't go get it. Brought in by Helm. Going wide off the stick of Yandel. Draper. Back in for Helm. Went to Eves. O'Coin knocked it down. Loose at the blue line. Lidstrom hustling over, getting it across. Stewart, the shot. Oh, Brizgalov made a good save, and that just narrowly missed going by him. Helm lets it go into the corner for Draper. Back in for Helm over his stick, so he'll chase it down near side. Helm will get there. Fends off a hit. Got it through. Eves. And Brizgalov appeases. Eves sent it to the goal. Eves back to the point. Stewart will shoot. Save made. Rebound. Eves shoots and Brizgalov stops that.
What a tough line to play against. A little frustration now. Shown by the Coyotes as the Eves, Draper, and Helm line work hard. Jump on loose pucks. Great shot from Stewart at the point. Relentless. These guys can skate. They can forecheck. If you hesitate a little bit, they're going to take the puck off you. A great line that has come together this season for the Detroit Red Wings.
Lane on Maltby and Advocator. Back for Maltby. Advocator held up by Anders Ericsson. Kevin Porter. He's on Maltby, who got it back to the point to Lebda. Shot went wide. Janik moved in a couple of times tonight to make plays. Forced the issue on that last one, and now Maltby will turn back. Back in behind the goal to Janik. Got a break, then lost it. Doan's got it. Off the skate. Howard's down. Net is off. Whistle goes. Oh, Janik got lucky on that one.
Things happen a little quicker in the National Hockey League than it does in the American Hockey League. And this is a play where felt comfortable, thought he had lots of time. But that wasn't the case in Shane Doan. It's a good scoring opportunity as he steals the puck away. You got to be so concerned with what's in front of you, but just as concerned as what is behind you. As the Coyotes are all over Jimmy Howard and the Wings. Very fortunate there for Yannick, and a tough lesson. Be a little sharper now, looking, knowing that what's behind him as much as what's in front of him.
Datsyuk is forced back. Then Hanzel will pick it off. That hit Stewart. Hanzel another shot off a stick. Into the netting and out of play. Well, the two coaches here tonight, Mike Babcock, most wins since 2003, and up against Dave Tippett, who's got the second most. And really, if you were to look at Adams Trophy candidates for Coach of the Year at the halfway point, yes, Dave Tippett could lead the parade along with Joe Sacco in Colorado.
Love.
But don't overlook what Mike Babcock has been able to do with the Red Wings, considering all the injuries he's had. Game 41 of this season. Red Wings with 14 regulation losses, only 11 teams with fewer losses. So halfway through the season, half a regular lineup. To me, this glass is half full, not half empty. And so many of the regulars on the verge of coming back this month of January. Mike Babcock's done a great job.
Seemed every game had a different lineup or had somebody else getting hurt.
Yep. But yes, Barry Trotz, as you say, and Tippett and Sackle, they've all done marvelous jobs. Yep.
Well, Tippett, Trotz, Babcock, year in, year out. Doing an excellent job behind the bench.
Here's Hanzel, and a backhand slithered wide of Howard. And there'll be a penalty coming to Detroit for a slash.
Playing their own zone. It leapt off to the box. An opportunity for the Coyotes. Just a little tap on the hand, but Pruka really holding his stick too hard. Bit of a surprise for Coyotes, a chance to get themselves back in the game.
Man advantage here
Point shot, O'Coin has got a great blast from back there as Jovanovski shoots, and that goes off a stick, off to the corner. Lombardi getting it back to O'Coin. Into the corner for Rafalski. It's tipped by him. Doing a wraparound try. Bouncing puck. Helm gets over there to get it, and he'll send it down the ice as Helm took a hard hit, and there's going to be a penalty coming here. And it's going to be to Helm.
Retaliation. Doan hit him first.
Red Wings are going to be two men short. There's still 1:18 left in the Lehmkuhl penalty.
Doan falls through on the check after Helm fires it down the ice. A little shot. Doan. Bit of a surprise for many.
And Darren's still mumbling to himself.
Well, with the minute 18 of the 5-on-3, it's a chance for the Coyotes, who, yes, they have played well at home, but their power play has not. This can get things back on track for them.
So the Red Wings don't want to have that one come back to haunt them off that call. So a two-man advantage as Helm's in for roughing. Yandel can't hold it in. Oh, Datsyuk. Yandel throws it across over a stick. Huge opportunity here for Phoenix. Conversely, for Detroit to kill it off. Yandel goes across with it. Back for Doan. Not a Yandel. Fakes the shot. Lang, Doan. They switch off. Sticks in the middle. Yandel moves high slot. Good job, Datsyuk, staying with him, forcing it. Yandel, Doan fires. Goal post. They had Howard moving side to side. Right play. Hit the post. Doan. Yandel fakes a one-timer. Lang in front. They score. Perfectly moved across. And Lombardi buries it.
Well, it didn't start off so well for the Coyotes, but they started to move the puck a lot quicker, and that created difficulties for the Wings. That pass through the seam is always a backbreaker. Robert Lang, who's great hands and great sight, gets a hold of it, threads it right across to Lombardi for the tap and goal. The perfect pass through the front of the net. Coyotes look sharp the second half of that power play, rewarded with the goal.
So that Helm roughing penalty does in fact come back to haunt at the 5-on-3, and he remains in the box. Yandel gets the second assist. Lang had made the pass to Lombardi. Lombardi was such a big scorer in junior hockey. Malfi couldn't get out with Miller. And O'Coin's back with it. O'Coin has got a bomb from the point. Had used a wood stick for so long and finally relented and gave in to composite. He fired it hard enough with the wood. I don't think he needed any extra graphite. Verbata, save Howard. Rebound, off skates, loose puck, hands up. O'Coin, Verbata fires high, sights were off. O'Coin, Hansel, Jovanovski, Verbata. 5-on-4 power play, Phoenix. To the middle, Jovanovski had it been in his feet. Janik gets over, can't clear, penalty over to Helm. Red Wings return to full strength, but Phoenix does get a 5-on-3 power play goal to tie up the game at 1. Erickson shoots in, rims around there for Pyatt. Lang in behind the goal. Put it in front of the net, but a hand pass call. 12:44 to go, second period. A goal apiece here in Glendale.
Game number 900 for this Warrior. Tough games as he plays a real physical, hard-nosed style, and the numbers very impressive. Detroit, second time around, his sixth team in the National Hockey League, has been the hottest offensive player for the Wings of late. 11 points in his last 10 games, 8 goals in that time, and getting stronger as the season's gone along. coming into this one, you'd hope that he'd be able to score 20 goals. Well, he's going to blow right through that mark.
Leno got it back to the line. Lepisto held it in for a moment. Now Leno's got it. Coppola goes wide. He's stopped by Erickson. Now turns back again. Here's Janik at the point. Off a stick and just deflected. Janik picked up his first point as a Red Wing. Up an assist the other night. Robert Lang to Lepisto. And Howard the save, the rebound. And Howard will hold that. Get the homer for the holidays pack and start off the new year with great hockey and great entertainment. You'll get a ticket to 3 Red Wing games plus 1 Uptown Entertainment movie theater ticket. All for only $96. For more information, visit DetroitRedWings.com. Red Wings with a day off tomorrow. Some may be going to the movies. Some may be golfing. What are you doing, Murph?
I'll be out at the pool all day, Ken, with you.
Will you? All right, then. You fair-haired... Gentlemen, you better use a lot of that sun protection.
I was going to say it's going to be 75 and sunny tomorrow, but I don't want to upset the people back home in Michigan.
Yes, we don't.
We'll not bring that up.
We'll tell them it calls for rain. Slipped in deep. Racing to the goal is Prucka. Hansel over there to get it. McCulloch. Shot is deflected and off the boards and back out to center. Rabatta. Getting a step around Meech, sharp angle shot. Big rebound all the way back to center. Holmstrom, Datsyuk, getting away from Hansel, left it there. Got some help, Stewart to the middle, then lost it to Verbata. Boy, this is an all-check line, and they do check, don't they? They've been terrific.
That's the philosophy of the Coyotes. Touched on Lombardi earlier on in the game, playing well both ways. That's the expectation that Coyotes have on their players this season.
Lombardi with Doan and Upshaw. Here comes Helm. Rebound in front. Puck's loose. Oh, did Jovanovski ever elbow Chris Draper right in the head? He's going to the box. They'll call it roughing, whatever. Jovanovski sure got a shot in on him. And how can he argue that? We'll get another look at this one, and he just whacked him.
It's taking Draper a couple of seconds to get up on the play. The Wings driving towards the net. Draper right there. Oh, Jovanovski clearing the front of the net. Both Eves and Draper in on the rebound. And Jovanovski doing what you want all defensemen to do. Clear the front of the net.
Just not to the head.
Yeah. Not sure how hard you run the guy over. Keep your arms down.
So Chris Draper took a shot. And with that, the Red Wings are on a Bell Tire power play. Stewart to Ritola. Fanned on it. Stewart able to hold it in. Goes back for Ritola. Down low it goes. Coppola lost control of it. A coin stayed with him. Ritola's got it one more time. Down low, he'll swing off with Coppola. To Stewart. To the net. Save made. Rebound just goes wide. Anders Eriksson. Off the glass and down the ice. Coppola off the long stretch pass for Bertuzzi. Cleared out by Phoenix. Back in for Bertuzzi on the left wing side. Power play continues. Lidstrom. Pyatt on Bertuzzi. Holmstrom gets knocked down side of the goal. Those were the Red Wing fans here in attendance, and there are many of them wearing the winged wheel in the crowd tonight. And it is a very good crowd here in Phoenix. Holmstrom got a break there as went over a coin stick for Tuzzi, but a blind pass didn't work. A broken stick for Holmstrom. Paul Boyer grabs him another. He'll get back into the play as Bertuzzi has it behind the net. For Lidstrom. Over to Rafalski. That shot missed. Lidstrom had moved over. And it rebounds all the way back to Detroit territory.
It's one of the risks when you fire the puck from out wide. So if it does miss the net, it's going to carry around the boards quickly.
That pass was behind Helm. Eaves goes in after it himself. Draper had gone in deep, and Lauri Korpikoski's away. Native of Finland and former Rangers first round pick as the play is whistled down.
Korpikoski has become a key penalty killer for this team. A couple of injuries, Fiddler, Winnick out of the lineup. Bench, the depth of the bench, the Coyotes have picked up, played quite well on their penalty kill.
The penalty to Jovanovski is about to expire. Cleared back in. Ritola getting it back out to center. Coppola forced wide by Yandel. Drew Miller backhanded it into Matias Ritola. Went for Coppola. Erickson intercepted for Shane Doan. Ahead to Lombardi, up with Upshaw. Lombardi saved by Howard. Over Doan's stick. Lombardi has the goal on the power play for Phoenix that has tied it here in period two. Upshaw with 14 goals in the year. Lombardi in behind for Doan. Upshaw crashed the net. Doan's got room as a result. Puck's loose and cleared away. Billy Lane, oh, look out. Erickson, nicknamed Bubba for his weight when he played here from Chris Draper, and he put all of Bubba right there as Leno didn't see him coming. Leno, the shot, save made, Lidstrom, oh, off the side of the post. And then up and out of play, and Brizgalov maybe got a piece of that. You're watching Red Wings Hockey on Fox Sports Detroit, presented by Bell Tire. News and notes from around the National Hockey League. The St. Louis Blues, with the worst home record in the league, fired coach Andy Murray, replaced by Davis Payne, who was with Peoria in the American Hockey League. So he takes over, and St. Louis losing at home tonight to Chicago 3-2. Rafalski, Drury, and Langbrunner, USA team with only three veterans going to the Olympics. And yesterday, big victory in overtime. Boston outdoors at Fenway, and it was beautiful yesterday, beating the Philadelphia Flyers. Was a very good hockey game.
Another great winter classic.
The
weather cooperated. League's been lucky in that department.
Marco Sturm getting the winner after Recchi had tied it up late. A comeback for Boston. Korpikoski toward the front of the goal. At the point, Lepisto had it hit a body. Korpikoski getting over. He's out there with Kevin Porter and Jeff Hogan. Porter going in after it, won the Hobie Baker. Back in 08, University of Michigan. Second leading scorer in the nation that year. Porter's got it now from Northville, Michigan. Korpikoski knocked down by Helm, stays with it. Korpikoski out of the corner. Eves got there before Porter did and saved a goal. Helm with Draper. Flicked off the stick of Brizgalov. Up into the netting and out of play. Well, Tuesday, get your game on Fox Sports Detroit Plus when the Red Wings visit the Anaheim Ducks. Coverage begins at 9:30 with Red Wings Live, and we've listed some of the plus channel numbers here for you. And for a complete list, click on Channel Finder at foxsportsdetroit.com. Once you find that channel, write it down, keep it with you, because you always know where to find us on Fox Sports Detroit Plus. And Anaheim leading in Nashville, 1-0 tonight. The Anaheim Ducks have really struggled, where the likes of Colorado, Los Angeles, and Phoenix have taken over playoff spots normally owned by Anaheim and Detroit at this juncture. But the Red Wings just a couple points out coming into play tonight.
The Wings battling to get themselves above that solid line. Los Angeles Kings win again tonight.
Yeah, Los Angeles and Vancouver both won earlier today. That's why they go to 51 points.
Talking about Anaheim, they've got to start making a move now. They're 10 points out of a playoff spot. They've got to get by five teams.
That's the problem. And with the three-point games, that's why the Red Wings need victory tonight. The likes of LA and Vancouver winning and Dallas losing is key, as Detroit can pick up some ground there. Dropped back by Kuka, Verbata, and that'll be held by Howard with 5:43 to go in a 1-1 tie. Second period on a Saturday night on Fox Sports Detroit. The Ferris State Bulldogs well represented here in Glendale. And speaking of college hockey, a Boston College star and a Hobie finalist when he was drafted 29th overall by Ottawa in 03 is Patrick Eaves. And the Bernstein Advantage brings you the scouting report on him. And Pat LaFontaine was his hockey hero. Pat from Waterford. Red Hot Chili Peppers. His favorite food is cheeseburgers. And well, they maybe go hand in hand. And Uncle Murray played for the Red Wings from 87 to 90. And his dad, Mike, a coach at the University of Wisconsin. Strong rookie year for Eaves. And then he ran into some injury problems. O'Coin with a lead pass to center, knocked off the stick of Pyatt, who has to turn back for it. Pyatt, 6'4", 230 pounds.
Now Eaves plays on a team that has injury problems. Good thing he's here, because boy, the depth that he's brought to this team. Mm-hmm. Big trouble with the likes of players like Eaves and Miller. What would they have done?
Eaves just signed as an unrestricted free agent in August. Boston bought him out the last 2 years of his deal after Carolina had given him an extension. And he was dealt in July from Carolina to Boston for Aaron Ward, and then Boston bought out his contract, which made him a free agent to come to Detroit. Knocked down by Holmstrom. Datsyuk. Bertuzzi was coming, so just kicked it to him. Then Bertuzzi couldn't go one-on-one with Yandel, who beat him. Rafalski. Nobody there on the clear around. Back in behind the Red Wing net. Rafalski again, this time to Holmstrom, is back to the play. And gets hit by Pruka. Rafalski has to go deep one more time. That went over the stick of Lebda. And out of all that, the Coyotes get a scoring opportunity. Holmstrom clears around. That's knocked down. Hansel's got it. Oh, Howard came up big. And after Lebda couldn't clear it out. So Phoenix made something out of what seemed to be nothing a couple of times right there after Detroit couldn't clear. That'll be tipped by Hansel, neutral zone over the glass. So a faceoff coming up.
Coyotes have been effective on the forecheck. A little miscue by Lebda, and the puck comes right out front. Hansel right there with a scoring opportunity. And Jimmy Howard quick to react. He's seen a couple of good scoring chances against him in this game. Coyotes, a hard-working club. And if you're not careful in your own zone, you're going to give up opportunities like that.
They skate very well. They do work very hard. And a penalty coming here. Who's this on, though, would be the question.
Oh, Eaves. Those Eaves on the way to the box.
Detroit 17, minor interference.
Against the boards, Eaves making a play on Upshaw. Running a bit of the interference. Trying to give his defenseman a little extra time to move the puck. Didn't have the best position on Upshaw.
Red Wings win that draw and send it down. So Phoenix goes back to the power play. Phoenix with points in 15 of their last 17 games. 54 points at the midpoint of the season for them. And they had 79 all of last season. Remarkable.
Big thing now with the Coyotes is their composure. Every game, no matter if they get down by a goal or a couple of goals, things don't fall apart for them. Last season, we saw them basically spin out of control. This year, it's not the case. They always got to be aware of this team because they play their style and stick with it.
Well, they don't have all the kids this year, and that's made
great free agent signings have helped them along the way. Coin, boy, what a signing that was.
Robert Lang's helped them too. And did not have 55 points until February 11th last year. And again, 54 now. 6-2-2, their past 10 games. And you look at what the Red Wings have had to deal with. They're 6-3-1, so that tells you, as good as the story as Phoenix has been, Detroit the past 10 have been right there with them. And that's why we say this glass is half full, really. But look at what the Coyotes have done since the end of November. First in goals against and save percentage. That's why Brzgalov is probably the first half MVP in the NHL. 27 team points, second best, and 12 wins tied for third.
They started great, and everybody was thinking, well, the wheels are going to come off eventually. But when you look at the December they just had, they're playing well enough. You got to think that they're one of the shoe-ins for the playoffs. Who would have ever imagined that even 2 months ago?
Well, they're on pace for 50 wins, and that would smash the other previous record from the 84-85 Jets, who had 43. So when you say playoffs, Larry, well, they haven't had playoffs the past 6 years, so this would be their first time in seven for Phoenix if they get there. But we're just at the halfway point of the year. And just over 2 minutes to go here in the second period. A 1-1 tie, power play continuing. Red Wings have done a nice job, though, here on the penalty kill. And Maltby will send it in.
Eating up valuable time.
And a stolen puck. Maltby will now go to the bench. Filppula joined on the ice by Drew Miller. 5 seconds left in the Eaves minor. Yandle lost it. Eaves out of the box. But Phoenix still with the puck in the Red Wing end. Verbata put it in behind for Lang. Verbata back for Lang again. Lets it go to the corner. Taken away though by Eaves. Up for Filppula. Up the middle. Can he get it there? Yes, he does. Here's Stewart. In alone. Save for Skolov. Great passing play though by the Red Wings.
Oh, lots of jump. Brad Stewart, the defenseman. You don't see this one too often. Real sees that Coyotes aren't sharp defensively. Takes it to his forehand, protects the puck well. Realizes that Korpikowski is right on his back. It's a good scoring chance.
That tells you how the defense wasn't ready, because it was the forward coming back up Stewart.
It's a play. Saw that it's a guy that knows when to jump up in the play, and there's an example of it.
Brad Stewart's been the Red Wings' best defenseman this season, you'd think.
Oh, he's been rock solid. Could be his best career in the National, best year of his career in the National Hockey League.
Yeah.
He continues at this level of play.
Well, he was a very high first-round pick in the NHL draft, third overall in 98 by San Jose. Only LeCavalier and Leguan taken ahead of him. Bertuzzi. Holmstrom. Got the pass through to Meech. Bertuzzi back for Meech. Didn't work. Holmstrom's got it. 35 to go in the second period. Holmstrom back for Bertuzzi. Hard pass for Datsyuk. Went all the way around to Rafalski, who will come out in front himself. Brzgalov held the short side. Datsyuk's got it. 20 to go in the period. Lidstrom will shoot. Scores! It got through! Bertuzzi may have got a piece on the way, but if not, it's Nick Lidstrom's first goal in 38 games and his second of the year. We'll see if somebody got a piece of that on the way in, Larry.
We've seen a lot more offensive punch from Nick Lidstrom of late. That's who gets the puck back, comes off the boards quickly, the shooting lane, and hits something on the way to the net. The key to this play is how fast he gets the puck off the boards and gets it down towards the net. Did it hit Holmstrom in front? Not sure, but he's standing right in the way.
Holmstrom was screening, but I don't think he got it. Well, they say he did. All right. They say Holmstrom did get it. So the Red Wings lead it 2-1, and that's a huge goal at 19:41. Lidstrom and Datsyuk assisting on the Holmstrom goal.
So feeling good going into the dressing room.
It'll be Holmstrom's team leading 15th.
Well, Holmstrom quickly gets himself off the blade of his stick.
Right there.
Up high.
So Holmstrom's got two tonight. Well, we said when we did the Arby's read a little bit earlier for those early tries that Holmstrom had the
fire the fryer.
Now he's got two. Fire up the fryer. Yeah, Mickey York back in our Call Sam studios.
All right, Kenny, thank you very much. Yeah, keep the goals coming. Coming up during the second intermission update, we'll take a look at the highlights through two, and we'll get Larry Murphy's thoughts on the game so far. But when we come back, John Keating will join us with a Coyote. Sounds a lot more dangerous than it actually is. 2-1 Wings the score after two in Phoenix.
Jimmy Howard has faced 25 shots. He's made some spectacular saves tonight. He stopped 24, and he's leading right now with 24% of the vote. The Red Wings McDonald's Player of the Game voting is presented tonight by the Big Mac. See final results post-game during Red Wings Live, and check your text response for special offers from McDonald's. And Thomas Holmstrom, with two goals, has 17% of the vote.
Thomas Holmstrom, no surprise where he scores from. Battling constantly in front of the net. Golov doesn't even see the puck when it deflects off his stick. When he sees Lidstrom gets a hold of the puck, moves himself quickly in front. Deflects it up. Golov, boy, talk about making a career on the top of the goal crease. After not the greatest of seasons for Thomas Holmstrom last season, he's definitely got his eye on 30 this year.
And he's an unrestricted free agent end of the year, too.
Oh.
Nick Lidstrom with two assists tonight. It's his third multi-point game in the past four. He's had two assists in each three of the past four. That Holmstrom first goal, by the way, Lidstrom from Rafalski. Todd Bertuzzi told us during the intermission he did not get a stick on that, so it will stand. Holmstrom from Lidstrom and Rafalski. And Holmstrom from Lidstrom and Datsyuk. On the second one, both at even strength, as Pavel Datsyuk gets another point against the Phoenix Coyotes, 43 in 29 games against them now.
You touched on Lidstrom. He's been much more assertive offensively of late. You see, his numbers are going to start picking up in that department.
And we talk about Nick Nock scoring and, you know, none in 37 games coming into play tonight, but really, as we've said before, who do you want on the ice at any time? You want Nick Lidstrom. So
extremely effective, just more focused on the defensive side of things.
Exactly.
He's a guy, no matter what the situation is, he's the first guy you send over the board.
Like him around for another 4 or 5 years, if he'll do it. That's for sure. Matthias Ritola getting help from the defenseman Janik. To Filppula, back in front. And Janik went heavily into the end boards. Covering up for him is Ritola. Back for Rafalski. Janik. Offside. As he waited, and Drew Miller didn't. And the faceoff will come outside the Phoenix line.
One goal. The Wings do not want to lay back the one goal lead. And in the dressing room, I assure you, Mike Babcock pressing this team to continue to take the play to Phoenix. He never wants his team when they're in this position to lay back. He's always thinking the next goal is going to be ours. And a good defense is a real strong offense. If you're playing in the Coyotes zone, you're not giving up any scoring opportunities.
Cross center and in comes Korpakoski on the rush, cleared by Eaves. A race for the puck and the speed of Draper and no icing. Lepisto moved it. Ahead for Doan. Doan on the ice along with Chris Draper. Shane Doan and Draper and Malpi, they were a checking line at the World Championships in Finland back in 2003, and they won a gold medal together. They've been line mates a few times. In the World Cup, Draper played with Doan. Applicator. Doan did not make this year's Canadian Olympic team, but he was captain for Steve Yzerman when Steve was GM for the World Championship team for Canada a couple years ago, and they won the gold medal.
Tough decision for to leave him off the team, but the problem, Canada probably had 40 guys they could put on the team.
They could put two teams together. Puck's knocked away. Porter couldn't get through. This will be icing. As the faceoff will come back into the Phoenix zone. Phoenix captained by Shane Doan. And here's where he ranks all time with this franchise, now in his 14th season. First in game-winning goals, second in games played.
leading scorer. And this game tonight has been very physical out there.
That's 73 points last season, 78 the year before for Shane Doan.
He's tall, he's hard nosed. Power forward.
Back in the Red Wing end. Stewart. Long stretch pass ahead for Bertuzzi. Had to knock it down with his glove and go back and get it. Gives it to Meech. For Stewart to Datsu. Knifing his way through, got the puck to center, then whirling back, took it away. But Jovanovski will feed to Sabinek Makolik. Rabata. Shot is blocked. Meech got in front of it. Side of the goal. There's Hansel. Back for Verbata. Back to Hansel. Crowd in front. Drew Miller will skate it out. As this line is now Datsuk will go off the Hansel line. Stays on. Filppula able to intercept. He gets knocked down. Gets back up. Hansel slow to get up. He's hurt. Martin Hansel's hurt. Przegalov made that save as the puck jumped in on him. Hansel's got a bad left hand. Hunched over as the Red Wings keep control. Lidstrom toward the net. Przegalov cleared it. Look at Hansel can't even put a left hand on his stick. Lidstrom moves in. So does Miller.
Well, now he can get off.
Yeah, Hansel's going off. Boy, if he couldn't continue, that'd be a huge advantage to Detroit because he's been against Datsuk all night. In for Draper and just offside, and there's a penalty coming.
Interference, Shane Doan. Once again, Coyotes taking too many penalties.
Phoenix 19, minor interference.
Too often. Bite back, Mike Babcock. Not like to sit on one goal leads, and now he has the opportunity with 15:46 to widen the gap between these two teams. Good sustained pressure. There's Hansel, he's discussion with the trainer. Can hardly put his left hand on his stick.
We will show you that injury in a few moments when we get an opportunity. Korpakoski, the Red Wings' first offer on a belt tire power play, and this is big. Four and a half gone here, third period, a chance to go up by a couple. Meech held up by O'Coin. Ablocator gets knocked down, stayed with it, puck behind the goal. And it'll be cleared. As Korpakoski got it down the ice. Howard moved it quickly to Filppula. Tries to get by McCulloch, he couldn't. And it'll be cleared down. Lidstrom will set up behind the goal. Phoenix penalty killing, seventh in the league. Red Wings power play 20th coming into play tonight. Datsuk got it through. Two goal shooter Thomas Holmstrom back to Datsuk in front. Missed Holmstrom. Went to Rafalski though. Holmstrom in front of the goal again. Lidstrom will fire. Puck's knocked down and Przegalov. I don't know how he even saw that through Holmstrom. Larry, we spoke of that in the first period that unless you get traffic in on Przegalov, you're not going to score, and that's how Holmstrom got both his goals tonight, and they tried it again.
With a shot from the point.
Ouch. And let's look to see how Martin Hansel got hurt, number 11, right there, as he went down.
If it's elbow or hand.
Power play continues, knocked down by Lombardi, went to Holmstrom. Puck still loose. Recovery, Datsuk, and he just whipped it wide. Lidstrom for Bertuzzi. Holmstrom down low, Datsuk in the slot. Now he moves off. Back for Bertuzzi. Great play from Holmstrom for Bertuzzi. Rafalski off the boards, Bertuzzi. Datsuk got it, shoots, scores! Pavel Datsuk rips it home. Power play goal, 3-1 Detroit.
With time for Bertuzzi. Brings it into the middle, takes it to the net. The seam's wide open. The perfectly placed pass. And earlier on in the power play, it was give and go. Holmstrom and Bertuzzi gets a hold of it on the boards. Brings it off.
He's got all day. Tetsu gives him the target, puts it right on the tape. The key to this play. Datsuk in one motion is able to take the pass and fire the puck. Bertuzzi throws it 2 feet in front of him. There is no goal on that play.
Power play goal, Red Wings 1-for-4. As Datsuk with a goal and an assist tonight from Bertuzzi and Rafalski. So a 2-goal lead. And that may be justice considering the penalty to Helm for interference when Phoenix is able to score 5-on-3. Would affect to get it back with the man advantage and lead by 2. But Lang trying to have a say in that. Pyatt with a shot and a save by Howard in tight. Brought to center by Eaves. No flipping it off the glass. Sammy Lepisto goes back. Carried by Yandel. Keeps on going. Janik. Took a hit, got it around. Coppola knifed it through to Lebden. With Miller and Ritola. Coppola, he was hit. Lebden held it in, back to recover. Janik got it back out to center. Ritola across center, and he'll send it in deep. Drew Miller forcing the issue on Porter. Phoenix will just clear it. And Janik's got it in his own end for Lidstrom. Long shot. But called on the offside. So Pavel Datsyuk has goals in consecutive games, giving him 10 on the season.
And against Colorado, Pavel Datsyuk. But hey, Duke got dizzy on this play. He played keep away. Nice little pass to Bertuzzi. The old toe drag. Sammy Paulson. And the delay backs off foot, fires it. Top corner tonight, once again. Datsyuk at his best as he converts the perfect pass from his line mate, Todd Bertuzzi. The three of them with Holmstrom have been outstanding.
Martin Hansel's back on the ice, but he did not take the face off. He's got the puck now. So out there with Pruka and Verbata against the Datsyuk line. Back to the point for Jovanovski, the shot. And that stop, Stewart for Holmstrom. Bertuzzi going, he's got it. Catching up is Meech. Kicked it ahead, just wide of the goal. Eaves to the net, hit a skate, deflected wide. Just over 8 minutes having expired here in period 3. Red Wings lead by 2. Phoenix has not lost in regulation in this building since mid-November. Draper. They lost their last outing here in a shootout to San Jose. Grab behind the goal as Eaves get thrown into the boards. The last 3 games for Phoenix, in fact, have all gone to shootout. Beat Vancouver, lost twice to the Sharks. Loose puck, Helm. Into the zone as Draper goes in and gets it. Eaves in front. Shot. Oh, Broskolov stopped it. It was behind him, but just trickled wide. Helm for Eaves. Delays a bit as the Red Wings change. Back for Helm. Escapes a hit, then gets thrown down to the ice. Eaves trying to get off. He's exhausted. Up through the middle. Pulled back for Krakowski. Don't shoot. Save Howard. Don't in front for Krakowski. Howard stops that, gathers in the rebound. I don't think either team wants to take a penalty out of a scrum. We'll score the $48 family pack. We'll see the Red Wings battle the Carolina Hurricanes on Thursday, January 14th. You'll get 2 tickets, 2 hot dogs, 2 sodas. Plus, all fans get a free Red Wings tote bag. For tickets, visit DetroitRedWings.com.
Coyotes taking the puck to the net. Large forwards tap in front of the net. Jimmy Howard, 5 wings back in defensive position. The Coyotes are saying we are not done. We might be down by 2, but we are not done.
Lepisto had the shot, didn't get through to the goal. Howard getting over. Lang trying to wrap around, couldn't get it up though. Mueller back of the net. Red Wings get to the puck first to the line, but not out. The pistol slashed at by Ritola, got the shot to the goal. Puck's loose, they scramble for it. Filppula, good work along with Miller, who carries to center. Three Coyotes back, doesn't get through, then Lang lost it at center. Valtteri Filppula into the zone, and Mueller will whack it back out to center. This is part of the five-game road trip for the Red Wings that starts here tonight. A few days off in between. It'll conclude on the island next Tuesday. Red Wings will get home for a bit before they head back to the island, but five in a row away from home, and probably later rather than sooner on this road trip. Henrik Zetterberg and Danny Cleary be the first two to come back, each with a slight shoulder separations, two opposite shoulders the two had. But hopefully before the trip is over, but likely not in the next few.
I know they're anxious to get back in.
And that shot deflected, and Nick Cronwall getting closer to returning as well. And after him will likely be Jason Williams and Jonathan Erickson and Franzen. And then we'll be done.
Where are they going to put everybody?
And we'll find a place. Lombardi, the shot, the save, Howard! Oh, quick whistle, but Lidstrom was there to knock it away anyway. It's about time the Red Wings get a quick whistle. You're watching Red Wings Hockey on Fox Sports Detroit from Phoenix, Arizona, presented by Bell Tire. For Dave Tippett's team, fourth game in six nights. The previous three, as we mentioned, gone to shootout. They're on pace for 50 wins, 54 points after 42 games. And because they've been so great here in Jobbing.com Arena, just the shootout loss their last 11. The streak broken on New Year's Eve, scoring at a terrific pace. Just 15 goals against in the 11 games, 1.36, and that's why we say Ilya Bryzgalov has been so amazing, and your goaltender's your best penalty killer.
They have definitely played well. Real strong 5-on-5 team. Second in the National Hockey League in that department.
Plus 19 coming into play tonight at even strength, yes. Right off the draw on a save by Howard.
Little backhand shot from Hanzel. He's recovered well. And Jimmy Howard, the opportunity he gets, if he can get a hold of that puck, will not allow a rebound. Slow things down. Don't let the Coyotes get any momentum.
But again, Hanzel still not taking faceoffs, so Larry. As Pruka has been taking them after he injured either his elbow or his hand earlier in this period we showed you. That was behind Hanzel and cleared out to center. Tip by Verbata. Lebda back for Stewart. Holmstrom took a whack at it to make sure it got out to center. McCulloch couldn't get it deep. Phoenix was offside, so Radim Verbata had to turn back with it. Verbata came over from Tampa Bay in a deal that worked very well for these Coyotes. He didn't finish last season in Tampa. He left to return to the Czech Republic in December. And this past summer acquired from Tampa. He wasn't going to head back there anyway.
Forward that loves to shoot the puck.
Yep. Helm. Draper. That is pass block. And it bounces all the way down. Rafalski to center for Eaves. And Helm goes in and a chase with Keith Yandle. They collide in the corner. Draper kicking at the puck. He has it. He slashed at. Knocked down. Peter Mueller gives it to Robert Lang. That hit Pyatt, who got knocked down by Draper. Now Mueller trying to do something with it. A little delay there by Janik. Cleared it off the linesman. And Taylor Pyatt brings it back in for Phoenix. He can't bust through. Ritola. Seems to have more and more confidence with each shift out there. Ritola. Waits. Maltby fires. Save for Skoloff. Bouncing puck went past Lidstrom. Slap back. Stewart moved it quickly. Filppula, Maltby offside. Ritola. As soon as the game ends, our coverage continues with Red Wings Live. You'll hear from the head coach and players. We'll break it all down for you. Red Wings Live from the Call Sam Studios with Mickey York. Immediately after the game here on Fox Sports Detroit. And Daniels, Larry Murphy in the broadcast booth, joined here by John Keating as well tonight.
We'll dissect the game, Ken, pull it apart, explain exactly what happened, put it back together. Some tremendous shows coming up.
Put a little bow on it.
Yeah.
You're still in the giving season. Nice. Dropped by Korpakovsky. Knocked down by Lidstrom. Datsyuk. On a return feed from Stewart off his skate. Has to find it. Shane Doan hustling in. Then Datsyuk got in front of Doan. Bertuzzi. McCulloch moved up on him. Bertuzzi wasn't sure which way to go with it as Stewart. Korpakovsky to the corner. Stewart took a hit but made the play. We've word that the Phoenix Coyotes' Scotty Upshaw is injured and will not return. That's a man you talked of, Larry, with 14 goals, one shy of his career high. The great start he's had, but he won't be back tonight. Well, with Upshaw gone for the night, the lucky Martin Hansel was able to return.
Down a couple of goals. The last thing you want to see is your leading goal scorer taking his gear off.
Yeah. Well, I don't think the Red Wings will feel sorry for him.
No. Oh, no.
Here's Draper. Back for Lebda, just like the rest of the league doesn't feel sorry for Detroit. Lebda. That's what happens when you're that successful, right?
Everybody's gunning for you.
Exactly.
Every time Detroit loses, the rest of the league, see, it's about time.
Yeah. Rafalski ahead for Lebda. Angled to the near boards, but tipped in by Drew Miller. Peter Mueller stepped into by Miller. Pyatt got it to Lang. For Yandel. To Pyatt, across, oh, and Meech saved one. As Mueller had an opportunity, but Meech got his stick on it. And that's the way it's gone for Mueller this year, too. Up ahead for Philpott. Cuts to the middle. Had no help with him as the Red Wings are changing. He just threw it in. Under five to go here, third period. Phoenix has outshot Detroit by one, but more importantly, Red Wings have outscored the Coyotes by two. Thomas Holmstrom has two. Pavel Datsyuk the other. Nick Lidstrom two assists tonight. And Datsyuk with a goal and an assist. Pavel turns back, and with that, Pavel Datsyuk has tied Henrik Zetterberg for the team lead in points. Here he comes again, looking to take the lead. A save by Brzgalov. Red Wings lead by two, late stages, third period from Phoenix. Thanks, Mick. It was nice to close out the decade with a win and start the new one in victory two.
Looking at the Wings' schedule for January, eight of the games are on road, including tonight, only three at home. So if they can come out of this month with all the players coming back from injury, they get themselves back in the playoff picture, then things look very bright. February, March, April.
Hopefully have some healthy bodies back, and they should by the time they meet Chicago on an afternoon tilt. Just over four to play here in the third. O'Coin got it across to Verbata, but Hansel was in and offside.
A little impatience at the blue line. Verbata takes the puck over offside, and with Upshaw out of the lineup, this is the guy they're looking for. And somebody that, if you get the puck to him, he'll fire it. He's a lot of players in the National Hockey League. You've got to convince them. Shoot when you get the puck. Shoot when you get the puck. Verbata, he's not one of those guys. He gets rid of it as soon as he gets it.
Helm just beaten to the puck by Yandel, but it came right back for Helm. In behind the goal to Draper. Yandel knocked it away, and Peter Prucka over there for Yandel, who went down. Helm getting over to hold it in. Eaves. Datsyuk, he's on the ice now. Datsyuk was hoping that Maltby might get there in time. Maltby up there along with Datsyuk, gives him the puck, he shoots, and a rising shot high by Pavel Datsyuk. Bertuzzi for Datsyuk, skate the stick, weaves it back, Rafalski in behind the goal, and Bertuzzi will go in there and pick it up. for Datsyuk. Quick shot, partially fanned on low. Bertuzzi takes it away at center. As Maltby's out there with this line now for a short time, he had Datsyuk and Bertuzzi. And out over the boards comes Ritola and Filppula. As Maltby goes off, Miller comes on. McCullough gets hit by Ritola. He's throwing his body tonight, Matthias Ritola. McCullough, that shot's blocked. Ritola's got it. Filppula joining. Look at this. There goes Miller. He's in behind. Filppula with him. Miller right to the goal. Oh, and a toe stopper there as Brizgalov came out. As Drew Miller had a chance far side. That was a 2-on-1. Korpakovsky to the net. Stick to the corner by Howard. They'll go chase it down this side. Lang. As it's poked out the center. Long shot rims around for Mueller. Howard the save. Eves there for the rebound. Dragons have done a good job of clearing away the rebounds that do get away from Howard tonight. In position, not giving too many second chances.
Even when they have gotten hold of the puck, they've made sure they've gotten out of their blue line.
Shot by Stewart went wide, and Helm made one great play in behind Howard tonight. And Howard came up with a big save. That was in the first period.
There's still a minute and a half left in this third period, but a strong outing, getting that insurance goal, not laying back.
And they passed the puck very well tonight. Maltby has taken over the spot for Holmstrom on this line with Bertuzzi and Datsyuk. Cleared out as Maltby was right there getting it ahead for Bertuzzi. Empty net as Brizgalov's gone to the bench for a six skater. The Red Wings had an empty netter on New Year's Eve to beat Colorado. Howard will hold it, so there'll be a faceoff coming up. Tuesday, get your game on Fox Sports Detroit Plus. Red Wings will visit the Anaheim Ducks. Coverage begins at 9:30 with Red Wings Live. We've listed some of the plus channel numbers here, and for a complete list, click on Channel Finder at foxsportsdetroit.com. Fox Sports Detroit Plus, Tuesday from Anaheim, 9:30, Red Wings Live. We hear Tamas Solani is close to returning for the Anaheim Ducks.
No surprise, Dave Tippett calls the timeout, gets the dry erase board out. X's and O's and arrows and do this, do that.
Well, there's Thomas Holmstrom not on the ice for the final minutes as Maltby's taken over his spot on the line with Datsyuk and Bertuzzi. But Thomas Holmstrom, you are Jimmy John's delivery of the game with two tonight.
All over the front of the net. Battles his way away from Mahalik, gets a stick on it, and this one quickly moves to the front of the net. Perfect timing for Lidstrom's shot from the point.
Thomas Holmstrom leading the team now, 15 goals.
Face-off, very critical. This juncture of the game. The Wings have won 58% to this point.
Matthew Lombardi.
We'll have two centermen out there. Detroit will, in case one gets tossed out.
Lombardi against Datsyuk. In effect, Red Wings have three out
there. Yes,
Filppula and Helm. Helm, will it be another empty netter? I think so. Scores! Darren Helm, too shorthanded the other night. An empty netter tonight. Seal this one. 4-1 Red Wings.
This guy has afterburners. Right side of the screen. Gets a hold of the puck. You're not stopping him at this point unless you were able to hook him down. Yandel is ineffective at that. Oh yeah, there's a happy man as this is a huge victory for the Detroit Red Wings as they get themselves on a roll, follow up a great game against Colorado, start this road trip off. The decisive victory over Dave Tippett and his Coyotes.
So 4-1, so consecutive games, all be with empty netters. The Red Wings score four goals after having not done it in 14 games. Helm gets his sixth from Brad Stewart at 19:08. And this is a nice way to start a lengthy road trip out west with a Day off tomorrow for the troops. And Howard, another strong outing. That's his 36th shot. He's made 35 saves. And all he's doing lately, Jimmy Howard, is winning. He's improved to 7-3-1 his past 11 games.
He was tested on a number of occasions in this game. The Coyotes, they didn't lay down for this one, and Jimmy Howard was tested a number of times and made huge saves.
The two previous games this year ended 3-2, one each way, and Jimmy Howard in victory back at the Joe beat Phoenix, making 30 saves that night. He's got 35 tonight, and for the first time since November 16th, the Phoenix Coyotes will lose in regulation. And now, after a franchise record 10-game win streak in front of a big crowd here tonight, many Red Wing fans, they will lose two straight at home and do not get a point tonight, as the Red Wings win it by 3-4-1 in Glendale.
Strong 60-minute consistent game by the Red Wings. The day off tomorrow, that'll make it a little more enjoyable for them as they scrape their way back into the playoff picture. And for the Coyotes, boy, they threw everything there, but it wasn't enough for them.
Another winning goal for Thomas Holmstrom with two tonight. More on that and other stuff after we send it to Mickey York in our Call Sam studios.
All right, thanks, guys. And I don't think I exaggerate when I say that was their best show of the decade. The Red Wings live crew certainly has its work cut out for us, but we have news of a coaching change, highlights, and player reaction from the Wings dressing room, plus John Keating's post-game conversation with Mike Babcock. That's pretty good. All that and a whole lot more coming up on Red Wings Live in just 1 minute.